here. Keep your haunch there. Move this leg from my left leg, slightly behind the girth, over to not only the rail, but to my right side at ease. Yeah? That also, if he allows you to do that, makes your outside aids more through, which leads later to the fact, this is gonna be a smart one, this is smart, which later also leads to the fact that when you ride from your inner leg along the rail to your outside rein, with your outside leg preventing the outside hind leg to get wide, the outside of the horse stays through, yeah? And not when he feels the outside rein, he says, what the hell, the inside leg, I'm going to push my butt left again. Yeah? So you see, a simple thing like that has a great effect on everything thereafter, okay? All the way up to Grand Prix. Change direction at the walk. No, I'm sorry, stay to the right. We went to the left. A very, very pretty horse and seems to have great brains, really good. Sensitivity with common sense, I take. Sensitivity with is difficult to deal with. You don't have that. Yeah? Good boy. Okay, go ahead then and pick him up again. All our work that we do in relation to putting our horses on the aids has to lead to the fact that we can create suppleness, letting go-ness of resistance in all aspects, physically and mentally, establishing correct alignment, yeah? To getting to the point where we can make the horse straighter. The stiffer side has to get more supple, flexible. The hollow side, the crooked side has to get straighter. Yeah? Okay, because we know in order to have correct collection with engaged hind legs that carry a lot of weight while going forward, yeah? Within forward propulsion, we have to be able to channel energy onto the hind leg. So, if we don't have a straight horse, I always say there's no pipeline to channel back to. Yeah? If a horse makes himself crooked, yeah, the energy cannot flow back to the hind leg. Correct? So that is what our training is all about in that sense. Go ahead and trot on. Good boy. That's a good boy. Make a circle first. Always think about it. Good. Tempo in relation to activity. Not too high a speed. Not too big a stride. Willingness to go forward to the acceptance of contact. That's right. Very good. One more circle. Make sure now that when you feel he wants to throw his haunch out, yeah, that you are not trying from your outside rein to push the shoulders right. You have to guard the haunches. You have to say, keep that butt on the line of the circle. And from your reins and from your inside legs, so to speak, you have to allow him to curve his body into the outside rein. There, good. Right rein a little shorter, lovely in the frame. So now the leg yield. Now this direction, when you apply the leg yield, he's most certainly gonna thank you very much that he can throw his butt left, right? Yes, so what guards that? Your left leg, correct? There you go. Because this direction, I suspect that the shoulders don't wanna escape, but I suspect that the haunches wanna lead. And in the leg yield, the haunches must not lead. To the contrary. The outside shoulder is allowed to lead ever so slightly. Really nice, super. Bend your elbows once more. Really concentrate on that. When you feel the haunches escape you, that you catch that in your left leg. The left shoulder has to lead. Position right, the left shoulder has to lead. That's right. I don't mind that when you counterflex him there a little bit. I don't at all. But make sure that by doing so, you are not eliminating the understanding that the left shoulder and the leg heel can lead a little bit. Position right, position right, position right, position right, position a little bit more, position, 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 right, 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 super, position right, position right, position right, good job. Keep your outside leg heel, position right, position right, let the shoulder yield a little bit, super, that's more like it. Very good, very good. Make sure that when you feel him fall past your left leg, that's the leg he resists anyways, that you don't address that with a counter bend. Awesome, good training. Once more, position right, there you go. Super, excellent. Position right, allow the right shoulder to yield, guard the haunch, position right, leg yield has a slight position in opposition of the direction of movement. If you can't do that, your left rein must be blocking it, correct? Am I right? Position right, good. If you've pulled past the left leg, don't catch that in your left rein, catch it in the left leg. I love it. Super. Super. Do you follow me there?
Yeah.
That is extremely important. Position right. Position right. Position right. Position right. Right leg. Position right. That's right. Very good. If he falls left past your left leg and speeds up, the left rein slows him down. The right rein keeps position. The left leg catches the haunch. Position right. Position right, really nice. Very, 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 very good. Super. Now stay. You see? Come to the walk again for a second. You have to be sure that these fundamental basic aids are understood. Because if you right now go and emphasize on riding shoulder in and haunches in, your aids are compromised. They are. For sure, I guarantee you. Yeah? So really make sure that you always say to yourself that what corresponding aid catches the escape in response to the other. You know what I'm saying? Okay, that is it. Yes. Very good. Yes. And straight is alignment, yeah? That he allows him to coordinate,
huh?
Right?
The toilet.
Right, right. But you also must understand what leads to straightness. Leads of straightness is not just that you say you go there, you don't go there, you go here, you don't go there. It's not. It is always within the education of an aid that you apply from training level to Grand Prix. It's always within that, yeah? And when you say, the straightness of a horse is directly related to the hollow side, getting straighter with respect to leg yield, and to the stiff side, get more supple with respect to the bend. And bend has alignment, yeah? That is what you need to remember, okay? Go ahead and pick them up. That's right, good. Rhythm, 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 rhythm. That's right, to the right. Walk once more for a second. To me, to the right, it is important that as much as you want to say, straightness has a lot to do with the outside rein. To the right, you have to allow him to flex a little bit more. Allow him, flex him into it. Don't overflex the neck. I'm not saying that, but make sure that from the right leg, you don't ride into that tension on the left rein, where you feel you want to keep him straight. Does that make sense? Yeah? Flex a little bit to the right. Have the outside rein steady as part of your outside aids. Good. Flex him a bit to the right. Good, 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 Good. And think about the alignment on the curve. From the pole, shoulders, haunches. Pole, shoulders, haunches. Pole, shoulders, haunches. That's right. Good. Right from the inner leg. Flex a little bit right. There. As you wave to the left, it gets a little longer in your outside rein at the base of the neck. Flex a little bit to the right. Yeah. Come. Marching to the next circle point. Marching to the next circle point. Exactly. Very good. Oh, good boy. Yeah. There. So that he does this one. Yeah? And not that you ride from the right leg. It's always an outside rein like this. That to me is produced straightness, maybe. You also have alignment there. But it's not subtle. Yeah? Good. That's right. Very good. Very good. That's beautiful. That is beautiful. There you go. That is beautiful. March to the next circle point. There. Good. Good. That's right. Little flexion right again from your wrist. Right leg on a little bit. Good. Little contact. Good. That's right. Very good. Very good. You have to say to yourself, as you develop straightness and as you develop the function of your outside rein, the outside rein must never be applied in a way where you completely prevent all flexion. And Ben has flexion, right? It's part of it. Good. Bend in the body, and the neck has a degree of flexion through the base, through the middle, in the pole, in the jaw, in relation to the rest of the body. So that's a boy. Yeah, that's a boy. Very good. Super. Super. Excellent. Go ahead and trot on. At this point, as you have introduced the shoulder in, until this horse gives you his back a little bit more, good. Tempo, contact, bend. Complete alignment from pole to tail. Good job. Remember, whatever the function of your outside rein is, that at the end of the day, you are not preventing flexion. Yeah? Shoulder in later on as flexion. Good job. Straight ahead. Very good. Very good. Straight ahead to B, middle of the long wall. Good job. And good. And now begin a 12-meter circle. Think of turning, bending, and riding to ahead to the end. Good, good. Awesome riding. Awesome riding. What you just felt there in resistance to your leg in relation to the circumference of the circle, where he said, you got to be kidding me, I got to bend like that and step underneath. So he sucked back and went against your left rein. Yeah? That doesn't mean you counter bend him. You set the boundary and you ride to it. Awesome. It's really nice. Super. Very good. Always remember that the first step of the circle is also the introduction of the shoulder in. So that you can turn is a condition that you have to provide yourself with in order to introduce the angle in the shoulder in. Lovely. Good. Turning. Good. Good. Inside rein has a bit contact. Good. Good. That's right. Not more forward than that. Not more forward than that. Organized. I love that. I love that. Rhythmical and steady. And now a little shoulder in. Good. 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 Smart riding with your right rein. Good. But not too open. Not too open with the right rein. Not too open with the right rein. There you go. There you go. So in this direction, as your outside rein says, shoulders, you have to come over to the right of the track a little bit. Let that be supported from a little outer leg. Out, good, easy, 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 steady, steady, way too unorganized. Less is more, less is more, steady. Steady, 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 circle, steady. Just steady, steady, bend right, steady, good, good, that's right, steady, very good. Your horse has to understand the outside rein within the bend. Good, now the shoulder, super, steady, steady, and circle. When you lose the placement of the front end, your horse does not turn anymore. Then turn with bend, Oh, that's awesome. Very good. Very good. And shoulder in. Super, super. And circle. And turn. Outside rein. Awesome. Good instinct. Very good. Excellent. Change direction from the center line back to the rail by B. Good. That's right. Steady. Good. Good. Steady does not mean that I want you, that I want you to ride backwards. Steady to me means organized forward and not loose-ended forward. Not loose-ended. Love it. Very good. Super. And circle. Good. Bend it. Left leg. Good job. Outside leg on. And he doesn't throw his haunch out. Contact. Awesome. You don't have to look down in there. Look up. Look up. Keep your nose in between the tips of his ears. Looking ahead. Excellent. Don't look down. Good job. Awesome. Love it. Very good. Keep your outside leg steady. Thumbs up. Thumbs up. Look at me. Not riding like this. Thumbs up. Super. Love it. Like that. Yeah. That, and again down the opposite end. And then ride a shoulder in. Make sure that the preparation of the shoulder in is that your horse clearly understands that a turning aid onto a circle with bend. Super. Good. Outside rein. Brings the front end in. If now the haunch, in relation to the stiffness to the left, escapes in your right leg as to where he throws his haunch into the rail or against the rail too much, your outside leg has to catch that. Smart riding. Very good. Position. Look up. Excellent. Outside rein. When you lose the turnability, yeah, or the placement of the front end, rehearse the aid by turning onto a circle. You cannot do enough of it. Outside rein, outside turn, too much neck flexion. Outside rein, turn with bend, outside rein, turn with bend. Correct from your right leg. Awesome. That was correct, Kelsey. Awesome. Very good. Inside hand to the inside. Outside rein steady, outside rein steady, outside rein steady, outside rein steady, outside rein steady. Do not increase the neck bend. If in response to the lack of response to your inner leg. You see now that this is something that is like a thread leading through the lesson. Right rein, steady, steady. Forward, yes, but organized. Excellent. Super. Right rein, left leg. Good job. Organized. Lovely. Very, very good. Very good. Coming out of the corner again. Outside rein. Outside rein. Outside rein. Pretend to turn. Pretend to turn. Good. Outside rein. Now turn from your outside rein, turn from your outside rein. Excellent. Keep your left leg on so he can't throw his haunch in. Super. Look up. Don't look down. Excellent. Good job. Outside rein. Shoulders. Yeah, a little better. So you see how hard that is. Yeah, how hard that is to get his haunches in, his shoulders in, because the haunches always want to be in so far. And turn. Outside rein. Outside rein. Outside rein. Turn. Keep your left leg. Outside rein. Outside rein. Outside. Beautiful. Good. Good. Outside rein. Outside rein. Very good effort. So you see now what we analyzed throughout is directly related to all the exercise. Do you realize that now?
Yeah.
Yeah? Very good. Let it walk for a second. I would like to finish up with a little canter on the circle on both leads. Just pointing out once more what you have to think about. He is a very, very nice horse. Good choice, Kelsey. Very nice. Wait a minute. I need about 2 more minutes. Hold it, people. No worries. Everybody relax. Exactly. Very good. Bravo. What a good boy. Super. Round in the outside wing. Good job. Yeah, good. Give a little bit inside, but make sure he respects your inside. That's it. Very nice. Go ahead and trot on. 20 meter circle, then canter on. Good, outside in. That's a girl. Did you notice how much nicer? I would have liked to have seen the trot a little bit more over the back, but at least you had a more organized horse, am I right? Super, good. That's right, right from your inner leg. Don't look in so far. Did you start riding hunters and jumpers before you started? Uh-huh. They all, I had people start with Sasha and rode hunters and they say make a circle left. That's right. Good job. Good. Right from the end. Keep your nose lined up between the tip of his ears. Super. You can glance to the inside, but you cannot look in and down. Good. Good. That's right. If you had to make a rollback turn or a jump off, I would say go. Look where you have to go. Yeah? But when you make a circle, look at me. Look at me. And you look there. You automatically think this way. And your horse will follow that. When you make a circle, your horse has to look at the next circle point. So do you. That's it, girl. More. Straighter your head. Beata is saying, thank God somebody else hears that too. That's right. Super job. Love it. Excellent. Outside rein. Left leg. Not more left rein. Doesn't matter. Outside rein. Outside rein. Organize. 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 Outside rein again. Organize. Not faster. Organization. And canter on again. Outside rein. Super. Pet him with the left rein. Super. Come. Yeah. There. Now just canter ahead. Round through the outer rein. Good job. Left leg. Not too much inside rein. Very nice horse. Awesome. Diagonal. Transition to trot at X. Hands down. It's about the organization. Chin up. Yours. Chin up. Chin up. Rounder, keep it, keep it. Again, yeah, we have to repeat that. Measure the quality of your transition, that the fluidity and the frame doesn't change. Not that you can stop the train. Good, turn to the right, organize, and canter on. Canter towards X, Kelsey. Atta girl.
See, don't you wish you had spurs right now, huh?
Atta girl. Canter towards X. Towards, 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 towards. And steady. And fluid. And fluid. You felt in the transition how sticky his left hind got. That again is due to the stiffness left. Good job. Good job. Look ahead. Lovely. Right rein. Keep your right leg as your left leg rides. Super. Excellent. Very good. One more transition to trot at X. Ride towards X, not away from X. Good. Sit up. Sit up. Hands down. Trot, 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 trot. I would have never cantered on there. You know why? Because the quality of the trot on the aids being really of quality was not there. Yeah? Okay. Trot on once more. And then canter. Do you hear me, Kelsey? I know later in the test you want to show that you can trot three steps and have a quality trot on the eights, a working trot, regular and resistance-free. Yeah? But you have to make that the priority because before you canter on again. There, and canter on. Organization. And off you go. Circle. Yeah. Yeah, left leg, left leg, left leg, left leg, left leg, come, come, come. All good things happen from behind. That's right. Power from behind, energy from behind, willingness to go forward, hind legs. There you go. Organized. Very good. Canter on to the left one more time. Just show me that you have learned something as to what training is concerned. And canter on. Yeah. That's it. Super. Super. One circle. Make sure that he's willingly cantering forward. The quality of your transition is not the ability to go backwards. It is that he does not stiffen and resist a forward-downward transition. Super. Yeah. And easy. Sit, trot, 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 leg, 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 organization, leg, 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 right leg, 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 leg. Good. Do not trot on until he willingly stays out in front of you. Leg. Yeah. Good boy. Circle. You have to get his neck a little lower. Little right bend. Super. Very good, Kelsey. Good job. You can let him stretch out. Good. But don't just drop the reins abruptly. Keep things organized as to where he stretches into contact. Yeah. And does not stretch his neck, getting behind the bit and behind your leg. Super. Awesome. Awesome. Excellent. Excellent. Very good, Kelsey. You can walk then. Very nice job. He's a lovely horse. Really nice.